Hello, friends and family from around the world. This is Mike with Daily Events Worldwide, and we are on November 11th, 2024. Welcome to another surviving day on the planet, and welcome to the Daily Dew, giving you your space weather update as well, earthquakes, volcanoes, and world weather. Always starting out here looking at our sun as we've been talking and looking at that large plasma filament, bottom portion of our sun. It finally destabilized, half of it snapping away and the other half snapping to the surface, and then still waiting for the rest of the images. Having a look at the last 24 hours incoming, this is where we'll see that filament action spiraling around the equatorial region, cresting into view, interacting with that large plasma filament southwest region there. And that did produce a coronal mass ejection, but not directly Earth-facing, as it was kind of directed southward. Quick look here at the last 48 hours outgoing. Closer look now at these plasma filament events that have been happening and unfolding all week long. Documented here with Daily Events Worldwide. Having a look at multispectrum, we do have coronal holes that are Earth-facing right now, polar regions and north of the equator of our sun. Just amazing images here with multispectrum. You can see the active sunspots, filaments, plasma ropes. And look at this. Cresting into view. These tall plasma filaments or prominence are probably about 10 Earths tall. Just a massive plasma event that unfolded on our sun today. Having a look at A1A, 171 angstroms here, at the active seven sunspot regions, five of them that are Earth-facing. 3892, 3889. Going to be watching closely over the next 24 hours. Having a look at these sunspot regions in motion as they are racing across the surface of the sun right now. Merging. Amazing stuff. That was our sun today. Current space weather conditions. We are under R1 minor radio blackout impacts from minor M-class solar flares today. Solar winds are coming in at 392 kilometers per second right now. Solar X-ray flux, as you can see, long-duration M-class solar flare last night and one M-class today, which was minor. Geomagnetic activity coming down to a 2. And we're not expecting any space weather events over the next little while. Having a look at the space weather spiral here, showing all of the space weather heading our way. Little green circle on the right-hand side there is Earth. No major solar events. Here's a look at the CME that was produced from the plasma filament. But as I said, it was in a southward fashion, so it looks like it's coming at Earth, but it will be going south of our planet. We've also got Mercury retrograde right now getting ready to come up for the 1st of December. If you haven't seen the latest volcanic activity report, please check it out. Reporting 69 active and erupting volcanoes right now. And looking at our sun here in solar cycle 25, this is looking at LASCO 3 solar maximum, as we've had double the predicted sunspot numbers. Lots of solar flare events and lots of plasma filaments like this one right here that just let loose from our sun. Now let's get to earthquakes the last 24 hours, largest being the 6.8 that struck Cuba yesterday. Still a large shaker. And pardon my apologies, yesterday I had reported that it hit first and there were multiple aftershocks, but the 5.9 hit before the 6.8. There was lots of activity in South America yesterday. Greece today with the 4.2. 5.6 here, Marianas Trench, Mog Islands region, Volcano Islands region, Japan with a 4.9 as well. Active volcanoes through there. Tonga. Deepest earthquake today, 420 kilometer depth in the region. But just west over here in eastern Indonesia, right beside Lubutobe, 531 kilometer depth earthquake. So that's the deepest last 24 hours. Across the American soil, no new earthquakes or swarms to talk about. Just some regular activity across the major fault lines. This is a look at our last 7 days for shakers and movers. Largest being the 6.8 rare earthquake Cuba yesterday. But I've been warning the last couple weeks, expecting something in that region. Towards Mexico northward though. We could still see some activity to follow all of this most recent earthquake activity. So heads up, Pacific Plate. Now let's have a look at world weather. I'm going to be showing you wind models today. So low pressure systems spinning counterclockwise, high pressure spinning clockwise. Low pressure brings rain, high pressure dries things out. When you see the purples, you've got very strong winds, tight isobars really close together like that, even stronger gale force winds, upper level lows. We've got some big ones moving through the Pacific and the Atlantic this week. Look at the size of that beast on the west coast and then on the east coast at the same time. Europe is seeing the same thing. So northern hemisphere has just switched on winter. Yesterday I had shown the polar vortex, the upper level winds, which pretty much direct our winter months, and as well the sun. Everything is driven by the sun. But yeah, northern polar vortex is setting up for winter 2024. And look at this beast of a storm for the long range coming in over parts of northern Europe. Ireland and the United Kingdom, be on a watch for a major superstorm. Look at the size of this low in the North Atlantic, right? This is forecast here for the next 7 days, folks. Beginning of December is going to be very, very interesting. Ireland, the United Kingdom, Northern Europe, Finland, Norway. Heads up, stay aware and prepared. Some major systems coming your way, and most likely will be a hell of a lot of snow. Having a look at these systems in motion, some very strong upper level lows. Overlooking Australia, Southeast Asia, and Africa. Still have some typhoons developing, but smashing into high pressure ridge over China. They're breaking up. Things again are starting to cool off in the northern hemisphere. Cyclone here developing for Madagascar in the long range, and some very windy and possible wet events for Australia over the next little while as they're entering into spring. Us, on the other hand, are entering into winter. Overlooking here the North Pacific, showing the low pressure systems pounding into the west coast this week. Very windy and wet, wild week ahead. Look at this. Atmospheric river of moisture will be continuing to be prevalent all across the west coast and up into Alaska. And same thing here. Northern Russia, Eastern Russia. Huge low pressure system here developing in the long range. The sheer size of it is just unfathomable. Unbelievable, actually. You know what else is unbelievable? Are the temperature transitions that we're seeing. It is quite a roller coaster right now. We're seeing warm temperatures, yes, in the long fall days here across Ontario, but West Coast and parts of Alaska, it's about to get very, very cold. Temperatures up in here are about minus 25 to minus 35 forecast for the 1st of December. And all of these cold temperatures over Russia are going to be swinging around the planet. Winter 2024 is here. We ain't seen nothing yet. We've seen some pretty wild weather over the last few days. If you want to see the latest world weather, check out last night's video. Thanks, everybody, for watching today. Hope you enjoyed the show. Stay aware and prepared. Stay young and have fun. And get your daily dose.